Any sufficiently interesting project is going to depend on perhaps quite large collection of libraries. Maybe you start depending on just one or two libraries, so you just put their jars in your project directory and keep on trucking. You end up having a huge collection of jar archives. But then, what if a new version of your dependency is released? You'll have to manually download and update the jars, and in turn, all of its dependencies, and all of its dependencies' dependencies, and so on. This is clearly getting unmanageable. Another option would be to include a list of your project's dependencies, and have anyone who wants to build your project go and download them all. Of course, they would then have to hunt all over the internet to find them, and they would have to check all the time to make sure that the versions they have match the list of your dependencies. Brutal, right? Of course, since this is a course about Gradle, Gradle provides a better way. Most libraries, or more generally artifacts, that you might want to use in your project are present in various repositories around the internet. The most prominent repositories are probably Maven Central and JCenter. Anyone can upload artifacts to these repositories as long as they include the appropriate metadata. Every artifact in a repository can be identified and retrieved by a unique set of coordinates. If an artifact has dependencies of its own, that is also specified. The upshot is, Gradle knows how to retrieve artifacts from all sorts of repositories, and will store them in a local cache to make them available for your project. Not only that, but if you have multiple projects using the same artifact, it'll only ever be downloaded once. Gradle will also take care of retrieving any transitive dependencies, and will even resolve conflicts when different parts of your dependency tree rely on different versions of the same artifact.